And let me tell you this. You know, a lot of folks, amen, will tell you that you won't make it. You know, look at them. They won't make it. They won't make it. Honey, they said that about me, amen, in 1994 when God laid upon my heart to start the ministry. New beginning is still going strong, and thank God you're here this morning, amen. Because I may be down, but I'm not out. Greater is he that is in me than he that's in the world. And glory to God, we're going to stand strong, amen. We may get knocked down, but honey, we're going to get back up. Weevil wobbles, but they don't fall down. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen. That just came to my mind. You know, I like these thoughts when God just runs it through your mind all of a sudden, you know. I don't know where weevil wobbles came in at, but amen, it was good. Glory to God. Weevil wobbles, but they won't fall down. We may feel oppressed, we may be persecuted, but Paul writes to us, amen, as believers, we should be on the lookout, for the devil is as a roaring lion seeking who he may devour. In 1 Peter 5:8, he said, be vigilant and be sober, amen, for your enemy of your soul, the devil, is as a roaring lion walking about seeking whom he may devour. The devil is after every one of us sitting in here today. If he ain't bother you and he ain't after you, he's already got you. How many of the devil bothered this week, huh? Come on, amen. If he ain't bother you, he got you. But if, amen, he's bothering you, he ain't got you yet. He's hoping to get you. And one of the things that he likes to keep us down, amen, is getting us to concentrate on all of these things that we talked about. And he wants to keep us away from praying to God. And most of all, seeking God in his word and following his direction. He don't want us to do that because he knows that God will bless our life and he will prosper you in many ways that you never would think of. But let me tell you what the devil's job is, to keep us away from God's blessing, to keep us away from the things of God. Thank God you defeated him this morning. You came to church. Give God the glory, amen? You put the devil in his place. You put the devil in his place. You told Satan, get behind me, Satan. I'm serving the Lord today. Thank God for you. Thank God for every one of you. Amen. It's going to be good for you to just look to your neighbor and say, thank God for you. Amen. You defeated the devil today. You came to the house of God. You came to worship him and to honor him and to serve him and to listen to his words. Because you knew the enemy of your soul was sneaking around seeking whom he made a vow. And he didn't get you today. Amen. Don't let him get you tomorrow either. Praise God. Be alert, amen, to his devices. You ever seen the animal kingdom? You ever seen the lion after his prey? Does he come out and go, I won't know, that wasn't a good imitation of a lion, but amen, it was the best I could do. He don't do that to his enemy. What's he do? I started to do this at 8:30, but I don't know how good I'll do this. But anyhow, if you can do it better, you're welcome to do it. But, you know, the lion sneaks around. He's looking at his prey, but he don't let his prey know he's sneaking around. And then all of a sudden, when he sees the prey in the weakest moment, he's over on top of it. He's got him. And he's got his prey, and that's the way the devil does sometimes. We don't know he's lurking in the shadows. And in our weakest moment, when all of these things come pressing upon us, and we're about to throw in the towel, he jumps out at us and throws a ton of bricks on us. In other words, when it rains, it pours, and he pours it on us. He makes us think about things, amen, we never thought of before. Make us do things we never ever dreamed of doing before. And that's when we got to be alert, folks, and we got to remember who's in us. As a believer in Christ, we got to realize that Jesus Christ is in us, and greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. Who's in the world? Satan. He's the prince and the power of the air. He's the ruler of the darkness. He's the one who, amen, promotes everything that is against holy and righteous living. He's everything, amen. He punches us. He persecutes us. He troubles us. But thanks be to God, he may punch us. He may crush us, as seems to be at times. But praise God, we're not out. We are not out. Praise God, I still got a little bit of brain left. And some of us, like the scarecrow in Wizard of Oz, we're looking for ours. I think that's the one looking for the brain, wasn't it? I got a yes from these young folks up here. They know. But we're not out. If we got a brain within us, amen, it says greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. We know that God, if he be for us, who can be against us? We are not crushed. We're not out of the game yet, honey. So that's what I want you to think about. You may be down, but now you're not out. You're not out of the game. We're not defeated. We have been, amen, knocked down, but we don't stay down. Thank God, amen, we get back up. How many of you like football in here, amen? Give me a grunt or something. Say, yeah, football players, amen. What do they do? They get in the gym, they work hard. I mean, they get in the gym, they work hard, they lift weights. Why? Because they know eventually they're going to get knocked down. Somebody's going to be a little bit more conditioned than they are. Somebody's going to be a little bit more stronger than they are. And sometimes they're going to get knocked down. So they get in the gym, they work hard at it because they want to be the stronger vessel. They want to be the one who is knocking the enemy down and not being knocked down. But even the greatest of the greats gets knocked down from time to time. Have you ever seen the player get knocked down and he just gets up and walks off the field because he don't want to get knocked down no more? I'm going home. This ain't for me. Have you ever seen him do that? Just walk off and not get back in the game? If he did, he was foolish because he's going to lose all that big money they're paying him. Huh? Right? Hang on with me. Come on, I'm going somewhere with this. I mean, even that little skinny quarterback back there, he can throw the ball, but sometimes, amen, he don't get the protection he needs, and somebody, pow. Huh? He's a little dazed, but he gets back up. And he gets back in the game. So you and I, as a believer in Christ, we may get knocked down, but honey, we don't quit. We don't walk off the playing field. We get back up, we get back in there, and we are stronger in the next game, amen, than we were in this game, because, amen, we learn how to condition our heart, mind, and soul for the trials that lies ahead. Glory to God. We are conditioned, amen, through the Word of God and through prayer and through worship service as we are today. Satan's goal is defeat us, but we are not defeated. There is power in the name of Christ. Amen. Serving the Lord is like being married. Man, I'm getting a lot of commotion now. How many of you are married in here? Many of you plan on getting married in here? The fact is that when we get married, we make a commitment one to the other. How many of you made that commitment and says, I take you to do wed, and I promise to be with you through sickness and health, through richer or poor, and better or worse, and all of those good things, you know. We made that commitment. We're going to stick together no matter what. That's what you're supposed to be doing when you get married. Hello. And if you ain't doing that, amen, refrain from it until you can be able to commit, amen? And make sure you're committing with the one, amen, that's going to support you as well. Twenty-eight years yesterday ago, I committed to that lady in the back window back there. And I think Kathy and Chuck are committed to 21 years, amen, this week. But when you think about committing, some of you are a lot longer than I. Thank God for you. You don't find that many in this day and time, amen, committed in a long-term relationship. But I committed, amen, in my relationship for a lifetime. When I came to the Lord Jesus Christ, I committed to Him for a lifetime because He is the source of my life, and without Him, I'm nothing. And the Bible says if I continued in the way that I was going, in the way of sin, that my outlook was death. And that's the eternal separation from the God who loves me the most. It's a physical death for all of us that's appointed to man to die, and then the judgment. But the Bible speaks of a second death when we'll look God in the face, and if depend upon our choice here on this earth, whether we choose to serve Him, commit to Him out here down here, or rather we refuse to and commit it to Satan. We commit it to one or the other. If we commit it to Satan, He'll say, "Depart from me, I never knew you, he worketh in iniquity." Your souls will be cast into the lake of fire. Eternal judgment will be cast upon you. Eternal separation from God who loved you is called the second death. That's a terrible, terrible place to be in, because it's forever and forever and forever. There's no end to the punishment that will be cast upon your soul at that very hour. But to those who committed to Christ here, He'll say, "Welcome home, thou good and faithful servant." That is life. That's the everlasting life that God promises in that verse that this young lady quoted to you this morning. "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." In John 3:16, which she quoted, it says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him shall not perish, but they could have that everlasting life." That's the everlasting life, amen, that God has promised to those who have committed their lives to Him. Listen, committing your life to God doesn't mean that your trials won't come and you won't get knocked down. You will, many a times. And in your marriage relationship, how many times have you hit some tough roads in it? You could have threw in the towel and says, "Forget it," and walked away from it like many do. But friend, you made a commitment and you stuck with one another. And bless God, you hung in there. And praise God, you made a commitment, amen, for life. And that's what God wants you to do with Him, amen, because you are the bride of Christ. I may not look like one. I'm not pretty, amen, by no means, honey. Let me tell you, or handsome, as the women would say. But, you know, listen, folks, amen, God loved me. And He says, "You know, you're good enough to be my bride," amen. One of these days, we as believers, whether male or female, we're going to be the bride of Christ. And we're going to the marriage supper. Christ loves us, amen. And Christ died for us and rose victorious over death and hell and grave for us to give us victory. He says, you don't have to throw in the towel. 1 John 4:4 says, "Greater is He that's within me than he that's in the world." Jesus is in us, and He's not going to be defeated by the enemy. Amen? Praise God. He won victory for you and I. When He rose, amen, over death, hell, and the grave, I believe He snatched the keys away from Satan and said, "You'll no more reign over the ones who committed to me." Amen? You have no victory. You have no victory.